From the Land O'Lakes, Minnesota Public Radio is proud to present Cinema Publico. As we look at the movies that you're going to watch eventually, if you ever steal your brother-in-law's Netflix password. Here's our host, the diligent doyen, who helps you pick your flicks, Harold Escott Lozano.
My guests today include two distinguished film critics. On my right is...
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Leonard Schmaltin, the chief film critic from St. Paul Times and Shopper Gazette.
Thank you for coming.
Charmed, I'm sure. And this is my colleague, Pauline Kale and Spinach, of the Minnesota Chronicle and Penny Saver.
How do you do? Oh, you are very attractive bourgeois type.
You don't sound like you're from Minnesota.
Oh, you have excellent ear. I am originally from Missouri.
Yeah, I thought it was pronounced Missouri.
Oh, I am from Eastern Bloc. I mean, Eastern part of state. We pronounce it Missouri.
Enough of decadent chit-chat. We are a couple of all-American movie critics from the heartland, and we are ready to talk cinema.
So, who do you think will win this year's Oscar for Best Screenplay?
The winner is Who Cares?
Boris, I mean, Leonard is right. Stalin had best idea about writers. Pay them nothing, then murder them, then pay them less.
You mean Joseph Stalin, the Soviet dictator?
Oh, no. Easy mistake. I mean to say Roseanne Barr.
Let's discuss Best Picture contenders. What do you think of The Artist?
Why don't they turn up volume?
And they need to adjust color. Everything looked black and white.
What do you think of Moneyball?
Typical batch of American lies about baseball, a sport that was actually invented in Russia by Abner Ilyevich Dubultorovich.
But performances were amazing.
Yes, Brad Pitt was wonderful.
And his fat girlfriend, Joni Hill. Oh, she was tremendous. She will win Best Supporting Actress.
Oh, that was Jonah Hill. He's a man.
That guy's breasts were bigger than Samovar.
He should get Best Actor for his betrayal of large-breasted American woman. You have a nice pair of Samovars, too.
Thank you. What did you think of Meryl Streep's portrayal of a cold-blooded head of state with the feminine side?
Oh, she plays Kim Jong-il.
No, Margaret Thatcher.
Thatcher! I hardly knew her! Ha 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 ha! Little joke!
Little is tiny! Thatcher is enemy of proletariat. Come the revolution, she'll be stood against the wall and shot by firing squad of 11-year-old girl gymnasts.
Are you too sure you're American?
But of course! I am the Yankee Doodle Dandy.
And I am his Yankee Doodle Dvorska.
You don't look like anyone I know from Minnesota.
He's no good, Leonard. I mean Boris. Public radio hottie with large thighs has figured us out. We are sleeper spies sent by Soviet Union to infiltrate America and help topple the government.
So you're just a pair of foreign freeloaders with no real connection to the movie industry and no knowledge of films. You know what that makes you?
It makes us eligible to vote for Golden Globes.
Tune in next week when Harold tells Natasha,
I've never tried this position with a woman.
And Natasha says,
just make sure you don't leave teeth mark on my samovars.